Protest had been focused in the capital, Kiev, but that changed when protesters stormed government offices in several western Ukraine cities, forcing one governor to write a letter of resignation. The situation in Kiev had been simmering for 2 months before boiling over this week. Peaceful protest began when pro-Russian President Viktor Yanukovych abruptly rejected an agreement with the European Union in favor of closer ties with Russia, a move that many Ukrainians fear means a return to the bad old days of Russian control over their nation.
Young people, they believe allying themselves with Russia, it will bring, you know, it will take them step backward. So when more control, more dictatorship, more regulations, more oppression probably. And as we see in Russia today, issues of religious freedom, human rights are very much violated.
Their fears seemed realized when Yanukovych's government passed a batch of draconian laws aimed at ending the protest, sparking violent confrontations with police and calls for the government to back down.
The president is to sack the government and to repeal all unconstitutionally passed package of dictatorship laws. If we get this result, I strongly believe that we can resolve the crisis.
Opposition leader Vitali Klitschko told protesters that if the talks are unsuccessful and their demands are not met, he will lead them in an attack. He already accuses the government of having the blood of protesters on its hands after 4 deaths were reported in clashes this week.
All I can say, we will do everything we can. I will do everything I can to stop the escalation and the deaths.
But Ukraine's prime minister says that while his government is willing to work with the opposition, the ultimatums they've given are unconstitutional.
Any kind of anti-constitutional actions in the capital should be stopped.
Sergei Rakuba of the U.S.-based Russian ministries told CBN News that the anti-protest laws are having a negative impact on the church.
One of those points mentions that all non-governmental organizations that receive support from abroad, they will be registered and...